If you are new to The Division 2, recently hit level 40, and don't know what build to use for endgame, or you want to do raids, and your purple or mixed build just don't cut it, well, stick around to check the first build that you need to do after hitting level 40 and will get you far on the endgame content and do well in raids. Hey everybody, Balrog here again. I'm back from taking a couple of months off. Today I'm going to show you the first build you need to put together to start your endgame journey. This build is not intended to be claimed as meta, but rather a foundation DPS build that will work for you and you can improve it as you keep playing. So don't worry, it's very simple to put together, but you need to farm a little bit for the pieces and maybe recalibrate some, but once you get this build with decent stats and numbers, it will carry you far into the game. The build I'm talking about is 3 Providence, 1 Cheska, 1 Grupo Sombra, and the last piece depends on the weapon you are using. If you got an assault rifle, then 1 Fenris. If it's a rifle that you have, then 1 Overlord, but I recommend using an assault rifle as your main weapon. And that's it. It's that simple. It doesn't have to be god roll, because in time you will get there, so don't worry. This build takes into consideration that you don't have or still need to find a good piece for the Fox Prayer's knee pad and Contractor's Glove. In case you have them, great, that's super. They are the best in slot in almost any good DPS build, so use it if you have them. What you need to do is to check out the map and show the targeted loot, and look for missions that have Providence, Cheska, Fenris, Overlord, or Grupo Sombra to start farming the pieces and the assault rifle or other weapon that you want. Another good option is to farm the specific pieces or weapons in the summit. So let's take a look at the build. First, on my alt that just hit level 40, for an assault rifle, you can get an MP4, a G36, a FAL, a CTAR, or a Carbine 7. For this alt, I'm using the CTAR. For a secondary weapon, if you have an exotic already, or a rifle of any sorts, or a good M1A, or a shotgun, those will work. So the important thing on the pieces is that you get them, or try at least to get them, with a critical hit chance and critical hit damage, and add gear mods of critical hit chance first to get to the cap of 60%. That's the cap of critical hit chance. You have to try to get to this number or close in order to have a better DPS performance. The rest of the pieces is just a mix and match, really. What matters is that you have 3 Providence for the critical hit damage and critical hit chance bonuses, 1 Cheska for the critical hit chance, in my case with this alt is 1 Fenris for the assault rifle damage, and 1 Grupo for the critical hit damage bonus. The talents on the chest should be obliterate, but there are other options that you can use, like Unbreakable, Overwatch, Glass Cannon, and the talent on the backpack should be Vigilance or Composure or maybe Companion. As the skills, you can try different variations, whatever you like, but the one I got here in my alt works very good. It's a Reviver Hive and a Striker Drone for more DPS. The specialization when you just hit level 40, it's a Demolitionist, but you can try and build the Gunner specialization that will help you do more damage and survive more with the perks that they have, with the ammo auto generation, the rate of fire, and the bonus armor. So that is it, my friends. The first build that will get you far into this game. You'll be able to do heroic missions, heroic summit, a little bit of legendary content, and raids, especially Dark Hours. Because Dark Hours is just a DPS check. You just have to improve on it by farming god rolls, recalibrate the stats. You have to build your, remember, you have to build your recalibration library for that. Getting better gear mods, getting better weapon mods. You do that by farming control points on alert level 4 or optimizing your gear on the recalibration station. And don't forget to improve your SHD watch as you keep leveling. In case you want to know more about what to do when getting to level 40, check out the video on the description below, where I have a list of the steps to when you get to level 40 to improve your character, and check my other builds as well. I will link them down below. Well, good luck, fellow agents, and if you found this video helpful, please help me with a like, and subscribing to this channel so you don't miss any builds that I create or any news on the Division 2, and this will mean a lot to me and help me bring more content to you. So as always, be safe, take care, and see you on the next video. Ciao!